Hello all, good afternoon. My name is Maria Abanga and I'm a motivational speaker, I'm a therapist, I'm an inspirational author. What do I say? I'm a psychotherapist, yeah. I'm specializing in mental health and relational wellness. Oh, give me a second, let me take this thing off. I think it's affecting the video, the sound, I hope. So yeah, this is my segment. Let's talk about it, you know, and I'm wondering what these three A-HOLICS can bring to a relationship. And thinking about these three A-HOLICS, I think of workaholics, I think of alcoholics, and I think of churchaholics. Okay, yeah, workaholics. I am a workaholic. Actually, I'm in the office today. I'm still recovering. I was down with the flu, something I don't know. I didn't go for a COVID-19 test, but I really tell you, a lot of those symptoms, maybe all of those symptoms, I felt them. I've been down since Saturday. I've been fighting it my own way and everything. And by God's grace, I'm on my feet, you know, not as bad as yesterday or the day before yesterday and everything. But that is it. And as I will have it, I was also on a 3-day spiritual journey to usher in a new month. So all of those things put together. But I'm a person of faith and I don't just give up like that. And I'm not so bothered. So I have this cap on because a while ago, my assistant was here. She put on the AC and I didn't want to stop her from putting on the AC. So I had to put on my cap and my jacket. And I'm not taking it off because I want you to see how sometimes workaholics, in spite of their own self and their well-being and everything, they keep working. So that's what a workaholic is. Somebody who puts work first and who is working. I'm not that kind of typical workaholic, but yeah, I do love work. You know, the truth is, if you stop working, you can become redundant and even physically, mentally, all of that, they affect you. That's why everybody is encouraged to at least do something, you know, find out your purpose, pursue it and stuff like that. Yes, but if you are in a relationship with somebody like that, a workaholic, what can you expect from this person? I would use my example right now where I am in my life. I'm a workaholic, and if somebody gets into a relationship with me, which is like a 1 on 10 possibility or 2 or 10, maybe 3 or 10, don't expect me to be available 70% of the time you think I should be available. No. If you have 40%, 30%, that's what you get. So that's why I say they can bring a lot of emotional unavailability because, well, I don't have that time to play around emotions and, you know, be there dolly all the time and everything. I mean, when we make up the time, we go have a good time, we are there, but to say I'll be texting every day or calling every day, it's difficult. This is not that stage of my life where I want to be that available, you know. So just imagine if you're in a relationship with somebody too like that. The person may not put you first. The person will put their work first. And you would think that this is so unreliable, they're so irresponsible and all of that. And it will lead to frustration and outright. Sometimes you can even get depressed. Oh, they're not answering my calls. They are not getting back and this and that and stuff like that. They are so, maybe you want to bring it up to them and not tell them that the way they are behaving, you don't like it, but tell them that the relationship is suffering. And if they think that they can make some efforts, they'll make some efforts. But if they don't think that, well, that relationship is what they are cutting down on their work, then it's for you to decide if you're letting go of that relationship or not, instead of staying in there and being so worn out. Another category is alcoholics. Alcoholics, their bottle is their God. Their bottle is the first person they're having a relationship with, not you. So as long as they have their bottle, they are fine. But if they don't have that bottle, then, well, they can bring in some fun, you know. They can start telling you some stories just so that at least you give them some money so they can go and get their next bottle. So, seriously, it's not worth it being in a relationship with an alcoholic. Or maybe you were in one and then something happened and they became an alcoholic and you want to help them get out of this addiction because it's an addiction. That's another thing altogether. You will have to put in a lot of efforts, not necessarily directly, maybe indirectly, like encourage them to get help, because you cannot kill the addict. You cannot cut it off like that. They have to want to, you know, let go of that addiction. So it's not easy being in a relationship with them. I haven't been in a relationship with one. I don't want to be in a relationship with an alcoholic ever, because I have seen what alcohol does to people. You know, I've had somebody very close to me almost ruin their own life due to alcohol, you know, and so I don't want to. Actually, one thing I look out for is for guys who don't drink and who don't smoke. So my margin is very reduced, but I don't care. I mean, I don't want that. I myself, I've been knocked out by half a bottle of alcohol. The day I drank one big Guinness, I got up like 24 hours later. So I don't go near that thing at all, unless I really want to pass out. So yeah, I mean, another category of such people is a churchaholic. You know, the people walk around with Bibles, the people who quote Bibles, the people who say, oh, be not ye unequally yoked, and all of that. Okay, fine. If you meet in church as they encourage people to go along, believers and believers and stuff like that, yeah, you both have the Bible to talk about together. You have all the church programs to attend to together. Okay, after that, what about the relationship? Maybe you are so excited at that time and say, no, you have to marry. This is the person God has planned for you and all of that. I was once in a church and I saw what being with a churchaholic did to somebody. I myself almost became a churchaholic and I couldn't even have any relationship because the people right there I was seeing in church were not people I wanted to be in a relationship with. And the people out there didn't want to be in a relationship with me because I was like weird. And they were like, hey, what else are we going to be talking about apart from the Bible and the passages and the things which are wrong with the people of the world and stuff like that? So even if you are two church people and then you get into a relationship, at one point you're going to get bored only focusing on church and those things, they tap you in. Your whole life revolves around the church. So what about the relationship? Is there any relationship? I'm not sure about that. So that is why I was saying that this category of people, they will bring you emotional unavailability, you know. They will bring you irreliability and they will bring you frustration, which can even lead to outright depression. And these are not good signs, especially now with the pandemic and all the stress. You don't want to add to your stress levels, you know. But on the light side, they can bring you humor, you know, tell you those funny stories and then you'll be laughing and stuff like that. And then after that, what? Maybe more sadness, more depression, more frustration. I don't know. So are you in a relationship with such a person and at wit's end, you don't know what to do? Maybe you have even gotten married to one and then times are hard, there's no money, and the little money they have, they're taking it to church or they're taking it to the bar or they're investing into new ventures which might not yield at all, and you are really like, I can't take this anymore. Well, do not suffer in silence. Help is available. I know there are not many therapists in my country and all of that, but then, well, you never know. You know, reach out to me. You can contact me through my website, or if you know any of my social media handles, you can reach out on any of them. And yeah, there are other counselors and there are other services available. There are social workers, I think. So let me take my workaholic self back to my house and have a rest. Today is the third day of my spiritual retreat also. So I'm looking forward to really getting more involved in taking care of my body. But I was doing sports all this while too, so it's not that bad. And do not give up on God, and don't mind me talking about churchaholics and all of that. It's human beings, it's not God. I'm talking about human beings, I'm not talking about God. Do not give up on him. I believe in God and he has done so much for me. He keeps doing so much for me. All what I am and all what I do is by his grace. So I will always end up by saying God bless us all. Until next video, right? Okay, well, yeah, if you want to subscribe to my channel, if you find it interesting, like, share, subscribe. I'm learning to do that, to build my channel and be more consistent with the way I post videos and the things I do and all of that. It's all part of growth. Okay, yeah, God bless us all.